Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome back to another whiskey review. Ladies and gentlemen, first, before we get into the whiskey that we are reviewing today, which is quite extraordinary, we will get into that shortly. First of all, I want to talk a little bit about some stuff. You see that I am back in my normal setting. The light is a bit dark, but it's autumn, Christmas time is almost around the corner, so I thought this will be the best place to review my whiskies. I am looking into some different lighting, so that may be worked out shortly here. But why am I back here? Well, it's just a little bit more professional, and well, it just looks nice, you know. And the lighting is something I can solve, hopefully. Second of all, the way my reviews are gonna look is, first of all, I'm going to talk about the whiskey and a little bit about the brand, etc., etc. Then I will nose and taste the whiskey, tell you all about it, give it a score, and then I will talk about a subject. Today I'm going to talk about the collecting of Macallans, some really old Macallans, and some nice little facts about that. But let's get into the whiskey, because I do not want to waste any more of your time that you are already wasting here, or should I say, spending nicely. Yeah, okay. Today we are reviewing Macallan Sienna. Macallan Sienna is a whiskey that is introduced with three other whiskeys in a series called 1824. Macallan was licensed to distill at 1824, so begin 19th century, quite old. But I don't know when they started distilling spirit, because on the box it says distillery licensed 1824 Speyside, Scotland. So this is a Speyside whiskey. Macallan is one of the most, I don't want to say popular, but well-known brands. Everybody that ever had whiskey in their life and knows a little bit about it knows Macallan, because it has a really high collective value, and Macallan usually is put in the same box with quality. If you're talking about Macallan, people always say, oh yeah, it's very good, high quality, mesh, mesh. Or if you say, well, what is a quality whiskey? Some snobs will always point to Macallan. I don't think that Macallan is that good. It is definitely good. It's definitely a good brand. You can't really go wrong with Macallan. Taste-wise, nose-wise, they make good whiskeys. The thing with Macallan is, though, they are expensive. There isn't a single Macallan on the market today that is cheap in the same way that you will find in Glenfiddich. A 12-year-old Macallan is about 60, 70 euros, dollars, pounds nowadays. You can't really find Macallans in stores today, except for the 1824 series. This is the next most expensive one. You have the gold, which is around 40, I believe. It's quite good value, actually. I think I haven't got it here. Maybe I will buy it someday, I don't know. And then you have the amber. I probably will get that. That's around 60, I believe. I'm not really sure. And then you have this one. This one is around 80, 90, depending on where you get it. I got it for, 72 or something, I believe. Or 80, I don't know. I got it quite a while ago, actually. And I must say, I like it. I will definitely pay that price again for this whiskey. But, Macallan always has this really high collective value. And the thing with this series, the 1824, they aren't really collectible. Except for the Ruby, which is the one next to this one. That one is around 200 euros, dollars, pounds at the moment. I think it started out at, I want to say, around 150. I'm not sure, though. Because by the time I got this, that price had already gone up quite significantly. And I don't believe the Macallan Ruby is really worth the extra price that I heard from people. Everybody says, well, the amber and this one are the best. The 1824 series is all about the natural color that Macallan uses in their whiskey. I will read a little story that's on the back of the box. Macallan 1824 series has been created to showcase the beautiful range of natural color found in our whiskies. Each expression becomes increasingly darker and more complex. Bob Dorgano, the Macallan whiskey maker, has handpicked has handpicked individual 100% sherry oak casks to deliver the rich color that distinguishes this expression, a single malt of exemplary character and flavor. So they used American oak as well as European oak in this. That's definitely the case here. I wish they only used European oak though. I would like to see a Macallan with pure European oak sherry influence, but that needs to be a younger one. I think Macallan needs to make a new 12-year-old or 10-year-old even with just European sherry. Not of that American stuff, just pure natural color, unchill filtered, high ABV. That would be really nice. This one is 43% ABV. This one has been chill filtered though, unfortunately. Because I put some water in this whiskey last night, and well, I didn't get any scotch mist. So yes, I want to try this with water because I have some tasting notes with me where you can clearly see that water isn't really the way to go with this whiskey. But we will talk about that shortly. Yes, let's see what we have here. Let's talk a little bit about the color, because well, they say natural color, blah 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 blah. This is actually a really nice color. I will let you take a look at it. I think this whiskey is, I don't know, at least 12 years old. I think around 12, 15 years old. There may even be some older whiskey in here, but I don't think it is because it's quite intense. So yeah, and well, if you have a lot of European oak and you get some older whiskies that have been matured in European oak, that whiskey most of the time has bitterness. This one has a little bit of bitterness, so that's why I say there is some older whiskey in here, but there's definitely some younger whiskey in here to give it that kick and some more what do you call it, impact on the taste. And this is the thing with maturing whiskey. And this is a NAS whiskey, non-age statement whiskey. And the thing with every whiskey, whether it has an age statement or not, is the quality of the maturation. You can leave a whiskey for 8 years in a cask, but if that cask is not really good or is third fill or, well, it's just bad quality, you will not get like the same quality whiskey that you will get out of a fresh cask or first fill or just a better quality wood. And that's the whole thing with whiskies these days. A lot of whiskey makers start using American oak instead of European oak or making a balance out of it. And I think it's actually quite sad because whiskey does really benefit from the impact of European oak. When you have European oak maturation, you get a lot more intensiveness, chocolateness, and well, with American oak you get a little bit more of the bourbon characteristic, just some toffee, vanilla, caramel, that sort of stuff. But I think the maturation, that the spirit that Macallan used, how long it matured, it matured good, it matured well. So even if this is like a 6-7 year old whiskey, then I am fine with that. And the thing is, I am fine with no age statement whiskies. I'm fine with that. The thing that I would like to see most on whiskies is actually no added color. Because you can clearly see this natural color here is quite nice. The whiskey has made a lot of contact with the cask. The cask has had a lot of influence on it. You can already tell that this whiskey matured properly. It matured properly. Properly. Yes, thank you, English. So yes, well, let's take a closer look at some of the writing that they wrote on the box. The Macallan Six Pillars. Number one, the spiritual home. Easter Elkie's house proudly watches over the distillery in Speyside, Scotland. Built in the 1700s, this Jacobean manor house is the McKellen's spiritual home. A really small font they are using here, so I have to... I almost have to get... what's the word? Not a watch glass. A spyglass. Yes, that's the one. Magnifying glass. Thank you. Curiously small stills. The McKellen's curiously small and uniquely shaped copper stills help concentrate the flavor of the new make spirit. Okay, marketing in my opinion, but sure. The finest cut. The McKellen takes one of the finest new make spirit cuts of any distillery in Scotland. Typical merge of 60%. Fine. Exceptional oak cask. The McKellen 1824 series is exclusively matured in sherry oak cask from Jerez, Spain. Okay, that doesn't say anything where the casks were made and what wood they used. These casks are filled with aged sherries and left to mature before receiving our new make spirit. Yeah, okay. Natural color, blah, 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 blah. Peerless spirit. The McKellen is celebrated far and wide by experts and discerning drinkers as the world's most precious spirit. Yeah, sure. All right, the notes of the whiskey maker. Let's see what they say here. This is interesting. The warm sienna-colored spirit opens with a subtle vanilla nose, persistent yet not overpowering. Orange elbows its way in, turning zesty and sharp, through tempering green apples and freshness and balance. Next come white chocolate truffles, chewy and sumptuous. Okay. With elegant oak notes for a digestive. Dates, figs and raisins lead the palate, then differ to nutmeg and ginger, with a hint of oranges and apples, before vanilla returns in majesty. In majesty? What? Alright. The final fanfare is gentle, smooth and warming. In my opinion, poor choice of words, but my opinion. Nice box though. Like the box. Fairly simple, but nice nonetheless. I like that. I always like to see that. Alright, so a lot to talk about with this whiskey. Another thing, McKellen has been known for using Golden Promise barley. One of the better type of barleys there is. Glengoyne also used it. Glengoyne stopped using it a long time ago. You can only find it in the really old ones. I think the last one is the 21-year-old. And of course the higher aged whiskies. And McKellen also used it, but they don't use it anymore. Some people say they use a mix. Some people say they stopped using it in... the end of the 20th century, so I don't know, but just wanted to let you know. I also have something here. Sorry for the long waiting time before we get into the whiskey, but yeah, a lot to talk about. This is my new glass. This is nice. it has some water in it, but I don't think that will influence the whiskey that much. It's just a couple drops. I got a new one. Why? Because I wanted something like this, something you can roll around nicely, something that is better for nosing. My previous glass was fine, but I just wanted to see what else there was on the market. And well, I came in contact with some glass manufacturer, and he said come by my store and check out what we've got. And well, I did that today, and well, they had some really nice glasses, and this one stood out particularly for me because of the shape. It's the same shape as what's the name, Glenkeogie glass that Richard Patterson designed. And I thought This is quite nice. It wasn't actually that expensive. But let's see if this glass makes any difference. I will make a video talking about whiskey glasses somewhere in the near future, by the way. But let's pour ourselves a wee dram. And let's see what this whiskey has to offer. Alrighty then. Not a lot, just enough to get to know it. So, put the thing back on. I really like the natural color of whiskies. It's a natural color in whiskies is like the same thing as paint on a car, in my opinion. Some people care about it, some people don't. But I always like my whiskey to have a nice color, whether it's colored or not. But some whiskies just look fake, and I don't like that. All right, I can definitely see some cask right at the start. There's definitely a lot of cask influence. Mind, by the way, that this bottle is half full, so it has had time to oxidize in the bottle. I will also make a video about that in the near future. But let's just say, if you like let the whiskey oxidize, whether it's in the glass or in the bottle, two totally different things, but it will change the taste and the smell of the whiskey. Most of the time for the good, sometimes for the bad. But let's get into the whiskey. Yeah, okay. Interesting. Yeah, fruity, definitely oranges. Yeah. Okay, on my notes I have, not in a particular order by the way, sherry, there is indeed sherry. Oak cask, definitely. Toffee, caramel, vanilla. Basically the American oak characteristics. Yeah, there is some of that honey sweetness mixed with oranges. But I think that if you let this whiskey sit for a while and let it oxidize in the bottle, those American oak characteristics starts to like fade away a little bit. Not that it is there, but really in the background. The dominant thing is definitely the cask with the sherry, and not sherries, the fruit, but sherry, the spirit. Definitely indeed the oranges, the nice full blood orange, nice sweet. Yeah, there is a little bit of that chocolate, milk chocolate, light milk white chocolate. The deep intensiveness of the chocolate. Not really the dark chocolate, but just the normal chocolate. Raisins, etc. They said. It's I can definitely smell some spices in the back, but it's the notes with this whiskey is kind of pulled together a lot. So I should have poured a dram like 15 minutes ago. Then it will open up more. With water, it doesn't do that. I have added half a teaspoon, which is in my minimum not a lot. But you should definitely like let it settle for a while. Then the nose will open up more. But even now, it's a nice nose, fruity, orangey, nice, pleasant. Really intense. It has such a nice arrival. Then it gets really intense. And I find water makes this whiskey more intense. I also have it in my notes. I haven't actually had this intense of a dram of this whiskey before. This one's really intense. There's no alcohol in here. I can't taste any metallic youthness or alcoholic notes. Not in the nose, not in the taste. So that's definitely a sign of a good, mature whiskey, in my opinion. The aftertaste and the finish are nice. The thing with this whiskey in the Arrival is you definitely get that orange note, etc., etc. It's the best thing of this whiskey is honestly the aftertaste and the finish. The intensiveness is nice, but it undermines some of the flavors, in my opinion. Really nice, really nice. I think the thing with my first sip here, I had water in the glass, and I think the whiskey took a lot of that water, and that made it really intense, because my second sip wasn't that intense. It is still intense, but it was definitely not intense as my first sip though. But there's definitely fruit, cherry, oranges, that sort of stuff. It is intense. You get a lot of cask influence in the whiskey. Nice mature. There is a good balance between the European oak and American oak. The thing is with this whiskey, if you let it sit long enough, if you let it oxidize long enough in the bottle, then the American oak starts to fade away and the European oak starts to take control. You can definitely tell that by the chocolate notes. You don't get any tannins, those bitter tannins that you will find in some older European oak matured whiskies. That's not the case with this one. Yeah, those spices they mentioned on the box. What was it? Nutmeg. And nutmeg and ginger. Yeah, I can see that. Definitely. For sure. This is a good one. This is a gem. Also those apples. Yeah, I can sense some apples. Not really those fresh apples, more those dark fruit apples. The sherry is also more dark. There isn't like this light fruitiness to it. This is just dark, mature, proper whiskey. And this is nice. This is a non-age statement whiskey. And those snobs that say, well, I don't like age statement whiskey because... I don't know. They are really missing out on this one. I'm not saying there aren't bad non-age statement whiskeys out there. I think that it's a huge problem in the industry, and I will definitely talk about it in a future video. But the thing with this whiskey is just it is so well made that I don't really blame Macallan for not putting an age statement on here. Sure, I would like to see an age statement on here, but I am really, really glad that they put a natural color into this whiskey. In the entire 1824 range, it's all natural color. And I really like that. You can just like see if you have all the bottles, or even in the store, like you can look at the notes they put on the back of the box and on the back of the bottle, and just compare it to the color of the whiskey. And that's really a big thing in my opinion, especially with this one. And this one is rather expensive. Is it worth it? In my opinion, yes, it is definitely worth it if you can get it for a good price. I wouldn't pay more than 90 for it, however, because the thing with Macallan is, and that's where we are going next. The thing with Macallan, oh my god, the battery is dying. The battery is dying. No, the battery is dying. And I don't have my charging thing here. This is really bad. I will get back to you shortly after I hook up my laptop to the power outlet. Because, it is dying at the moment. So I'll be back. All right. Let me get back into my seats. Ah, there we go. Okay. I saved it. Yes, good. All right. Where was I? The thing with McAllen's. Yes. I don't actually think this one has it. No, it doesn't. I believe. No. At the like more age statement McAllen's and the more expensive McAllen's. The 12-year fine oak has it. The normal 12-year-old sherry has it. 18-year-old sherry has it. I don't actually know why this one doesn't have it. I don't think the other 1824 series whiskies have it as well then. Maybe the Ruby. I don't know. McAllen is kind of strange. But. Yeah, what do they have, you ask? Well, what those whiskey have is a holographic seal. Don't you think it's a bit overkill, Ronald? Well, not exactly. The thing with McAllen is their older whiskies, like really old whiskies of McAllen, are highly valuable, are highly collected, and are just liquid gold for some people. Some whiskies of McAllen are just... The prices are outrageous compared to the quality of the whiskey you get. But, like, that's the thing with whiskies these days. Whiskies are sought off after for, well, their value. Because, well, putting money in the bank doesn't really give you money anymore now, does it? And, well, whiskies tend to, like, skyrocket in value a lot these days. Especially some Artback whiskies. Balvenie whiskies are highly collectible. What do we have? McAllen, of course. And just some other old ones. Highland Park, yes, that one, the older Highland Parks are really, really valuable. Glenfiddich also, just the really old ones, special editions, that kind of stuff. And well, McAllen is one of the top, top brands when it comes to auction whiskies and that sort of stuff. And the thing why they put a holographic seal on their whiskey is because, well, whiskeys get faked a lot these days, and well, you see, with a holographic seal you can't do that. The thing with faking whiskey, it is actually a really big problem at auctions these days, and well, McAllen's tend to get faked a lot, like a whole lot. And, well, that's why a lot of McAllen's have those things these days. And the thing, like, I personally, I buy whiskey for drinking purposes. And those people that go to auctions buy really old McAllen's, really old Highland Parks. Those people often tend to just keep it closed and put it away somewhere as an investment. In my opinion, just that's just bad. It's a beverage. It should be enjoyed. It. What is my laptop doing? I don't know if you can actually hear that. If so, then I need to shut it up. What is the crazy thing doing? Okay, I don't even know. But my opinion, they should just stop with the whole making whiskey expensive because, well, a lot of collectors buy it. Take, for example, Artback Kelpie, one of the most recent special editions from a brand that is sought after collection purposes. That whiskey costs new around 100. Is it worth that? No. Do people buy it? Yes, because all those like special edition art bags and all the other distillery brands I talked about, they will just go up in value in a couple of years. And the Kelpie was, by the way, a non-age statement whiskey. It wasn't really that special. It would have been worth like max 70 euros, dollars, pounds. But the thing is, they just put on the price tag because people will buy it anyway. Not for drinking, no. that's a collector's whiskey. That's a whiskey you put on the shelf to look at and sell it on when, well, the price has quadrupled in value. That's the thing that I just don't like. Whiskey distillers should not, for my life, think about supporting that kind of behavior. Because it is just stupid, in my opinion. It's just stupid. And, well, if they stop doing that and just... It needs to stop. The thing, also, with these, like, really expensive whiskey collections, they get robbed a lot these days. There are actually just black markets for just whiskey alone. And that's also a thing. You can easily sell it on. Like, there's no trace mechanism, there's just nothing. You can just steal a bottle of whiskey, go to your local liquor buyer person, sell it on eBay for all I care. It just disappears, you know, and you lost your valuable bottle. And, of course, I have some closed bottles upstairs. I tend to buy some whiskeys that I may not be able to get later just because, well, they start creating it, it gets scarce, prices go up, that kind of stuff. But I don't buy a bottle for, let's say, Kelpie. I have thought about it, didn't do it in the end. Just to put aside, not drink it, sell it on in a couple of years for 300 euros. Because that's the case. Whiskies go up instantly in value. It's insane, it's crazy. And I refuse to support that behavior. I just don't support it. I want to know what you think of it, by the way. There are some people that say, well, that way I can grow my collection, etc., etc. That's fine. But the thing is, the thing that throws me off is buying a bottle for the sole purpose of selling it on later. If you buy a bottle and you say, well, that looks like a nice whiskey, I want to buy it, it has good value, it is nice, I like the brand, whatever. And you want to drink it. But you leave it closed because you haven't got around to it, or yeah, you're just saving it for a special occasion, because that's also the case with whiskeys. Whiskeys stay closed because people forget about them. I don't know how that's possible, but hey. And people save them for special occasions, weddings, New Year's Eve, Christmas Eve, that sort of stuff. And then someday they see that their whiskey is worth 5 times as much. And they say, oh my god, I'm going to sell it on. That is fine. You bought that whiskey not to make a profit. You bought that whiskey to be enjoyed, to be drinking, to share with friends. You bought it for the reason it was intended to put on the market in the first place. And that's the thing. And if distillers stop supporting like those collective behaviors, then this would be a better whiskey world in general. I can rant on this for hours and hours, but in my opinion, they should just stop. They should just stop with it and just let people enjoy the whiskey and stop pushing so many non-age statement, collection, limited edition stuff that is just purely put on the market for the collectors. Because that is the case. They are not aiming for the normal regular customer. They are aiming for the collectors, because there is a huge number of whiskey collectors out there. Professional collectors and amateur collectors like me. And the thing is, because those professional collectors have such big budgets, normal collectors like me, amateur collectors, can't buy those types of whiskeys. They just can't. I mean, you need to be in the right place at the right time, of course, to even have access to, let's say, an auction or something. But when you get to an auction or look at an auction online, I do that all the time, I see these whiskeys and I think, that's a good price for that whiskey. I would pay that. And then I see just 2 zeros, 3 zeros. And I think to myself, oh my god, that is just not normal. And I can just already tell that it's just some collector, and that poor little whiskey is just gonna end up on a shelf and not being opened, not being loved, just being handled as a gold bar, for example, you know? And I just don't think that's the right way. I think whiskeys are meant to enjoy it, meant to share with friends, and get some good memories out of whiskeys. That's definitely what I was doing with this Macallan the last couple of months. I highly suggest you buy this. I have actually forgot to give it a score. I gave this a score of 9, I would say. It's really damn good. The whole package that it comes in is good. If it had had an age statement, that would have been amazing. But I'm not going to hold a grudge to Macallan for doing that. They delivered a fine, nice whiskey. I'm not going to get my balls in a twist and talk about the things that's not good with this whiskey. I like this whiskey. I suggest you get it. If you're a sherry whiskey fan, you like some orange in your whiskey, then yes, this is definitely a whiskey you should get. I thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please leave a thumbs up. I thank you, and I see you later. Goodbye.